Once again, good morning and good evening for everybody who has joined this course, the session today, the demo session for the performance testing in DevOps crash course. So today, in the next 30 minutes, 40 minutes, I will try to provide an overall view on what we are going to learn out of this crash course. What are the various topics that will be covered? And various aspect of the crash course is what we will I'll cover it in the next 30 to 40 minutes. If you have any questions, feel free to ask either during my discussion or even after the session is over. You can post your questions in the chat or you can voice it out. Okay, so the next 30 minutes you're going to get a very quick preview of all the topics what we are going to cover during the 5-hour crash course. So first of all, this is going to be a 5-hour crash course, 2.5 hours on the first day and the 2.5 hours on the second day. So the course is going to be held on next week. Next week, Saturday, the same time, next week, Saturday and Sunday. And okay, so that is more about the timing and the date of the course. The way we have designed this crash course, right? The DevOps is kind of a very magic word or a very popular word the last couple of years. It's been there for 2 to 3 years. People are talking about it. But when it comes to performance testing in DevOps, right? Still, there are a lot of perception about performance testing in DevOps. So whether it's going to be possible or not, whether is it really happening or not, right? In the real DevOps world, there are a lot of things happening. When I say real world, DevOps from a development perspective, from deployment perspective, from functional testing perspective, right? So DevOps is just not only for one aspect, it's for entire life cycle, right? Starting from your development till it goes to deployment. But when it comes to, so which means if you're going to go and look for something to learn about DevOps, right? Learn about DevOps, you'll get a lot of things and 90% of the content, what you will get it from the Google or from the YouTube or internet, it is going to be generic in nature and it will be across the life cycle, right? Because obviously DevOps is a bigger picture and it is more applicable for development, deployment, and then continuous testing with functional. Lot of aspects are there, but when it comes to performance, right, there are things that might not really work out similar to the way continuous deployment will happen or continuous testing will happen. So from a performance perspective, still the maturity in the market is not that great for various reasons. So what we will try to learn from the crash courses to start with, what are our boundaries? Okay, what kind of a DevOps, what kind of a automated performance testing we are doing it in real world, and what is applicable, what is not applicable, what is the boundary of our performance testing when it comes to DevOps, when it comes to the execution in Jenkins or any of your DevOps tool. So we'll try to understand what are the various myths, various facts, what are the boundary within which we as a performance tester will operate. Is it required for me to learn all the DevOps technology? We are not going to be a DevOps engineer, right? The first thing we need to understand is we are, first of all, a performance tester or a performance engineer, or a couple of you might be a functional tester who are also doing a little bit of performance, or maybe a couple of people who have joined might be a DevOps engineer really, and they might want to even know about how to bring in performance into their environment, right? So for all these things, you as a performance tester or engineer, is it really not required to learn everything that DevOps uses, or a typical DevOps engineer should know it, right? Our scope of work, from a performance perspective, we should know what is it first of all I should learn. it is a vast world. DevOps is something, it's very vast. In that, what is a skill set I should know, that I should learn, so that it will be easy for me to go and say, I know how to bring in performance testing as part of the DevOps. I know this, these kind of a tools which will help me to work in a DevOps project where I need to automate JMeter or automate load runner, right? So that is what we are going to cover as part of the course. Whatever relevant within the boundary of our scope for the performance testing is what we will try to learn from the course. Okay. So when it comes to these boundary, right? There are a lot of things. There are tools, our own cloud, which we need to, which a DevOps engineer will try to act upon. There are a lot of things around the cloud management itself, right? Like infra, managing the infra, and then setting up this environment automatically, deployment in the cloud. Of course, the DevOps engineer should also know a couple of good programs, right? Programming skills should be there with respect to either Java or Python, or a lot of Windows or Linux-based automation for deployments. So a lot of skill set is required from an engineering, from a DevOps engineer perspective. He should be a very good system administrator. He should be a good cloud management capability. He should have it. And he should know about Docker's, Kubernetes, good programming skills. A lot of things are required from an actual DevOps engineer perspective, right? But when it comes to performance testing and DevOps in performance testing, we can expand wherever you wanted to. But to start with, right? To start with, it is very much mandatory and just enough to learn these things, what we going to see it in the course, okay? Mostly from Jenkins, right? Jenkins is a very popular build tool, popular pipeline tool. So in the course, we will try to start with Jenkins. We will cover these tools, right? Very specifically, that is practically used in the our performance testing scope. Okay, Jenkins with JMeter, and then for the continuous load testing. So you create a JMeter in the project, JMeter scripts in the project, and you do a load testing, stress testing, endurance testing. And once the first release is completed, right? And then if your project is running in Agile, if it is running in a sprint-based mode, where continuous deployment is happening, more or less your development team or project team will ask you to automate your auto performance testing, which means you will not go and start your load test. Automatically, when a build is deployed, the JMeter has to get triggered, which means you need to integrate JMeter into Jenkins, right? Or JMeter into any of the build tools. So first thing is we need to bring in the load testing into the picture, into the automated performance tool, which means Jenkins with JMeter is what we will just 1 second. Okay, so we'll learn about a couple of things with respect to Jenkins and JMeter. I'll come to that, what we're going to learn. At eye level, we'll look into the Jenkins JMeter. We'll also look into the Jenkins with, say, for versus load testing, right? We are automating the load testing. We're automating your stress testing, all the your execution part. Second, the monitoring, right? So monitoring also should be automated, because we cannot still go with the old way of going into Perfmon or going into Linux boss to look into your top command or VM start command. So that monitoring is also has to be automated. So the second is going to be continuous monitoring. So we'll make use of two tools in the course. One is the TickStack, the Telegraph and FlexDB chronograph of automatically monitoring your server metrics. And we'll also look into the AppDynamics monitoring, how to integrate Jenkins with AppDynamics. So I also have a live application in my laptop where that will be connected to AppDynamics, and then the AppDynamics will be integrated into a Jenkins. And I'll shortly show those tools and everything live, more from a preview perspective. But second thing what we will learn is continuous monitoring. From a one from an open source Telegraph in FlexDB combination. Second is going to be AppDynamics. So third is going to be everywhere you learn about single user performance, right? Everywhere you hear about single user performance, client side performance. So next is how to integrate the client side performance into the your DevOps, into the automated performance, because your functional testing teams are going to run their automation scripts in the pipeline in the Jenkins. So using Selenium, how to get the single user performance, how to get your client side performance, like your load time, your DOM loading time, your time to first byte, time to first paint. There are a lot of metrics we can get it from the Selenium. So we will look into what are those metrics, how to get those metrics from Selenium, and then so that as well practically we'll look into it. So all these three things are from the performance perspective, Jenkins JMeter, Jenkins AppDynamics, and then Telegraph InflexDB, and then Selenium for the client side performance. All these things are very much required from an automated performance world. And then two more external channel we will try to understand, GitHub and Slack, because most of the cases, right, there are going to be a source repository from which the latest scripts will be downloaded. Say, for example, you from offshore will be creating some scripts, from onsite somebody will be creating JMeter scripts, and they might be checking in those scripts to the common repository, because in the Jenkins world, Jenkins has to go and take the latest script, right? It should know where is the latest scripts. So most of the cases, even your source code will be there in the GitHub. And similarly, we can also upload our latest scripts within the team. You can store it in the GitHub. So we'll also see how Jenkins is going to take the latest scripts from GitHub, and it's going to make use of that for the execution. And then second external channel is going to be a Slack kind of a channel. You might have heard about Teams, Slack, all these things are communication channel, right? So the feedback is going to be important when it comes to Jenkins, when it comes to automated testing. Your test is running, your test is completed. Some kind of a feedback has to be sent to the user, right? Earlier, it used to be emails. We can still send emails. That is also, we'll look into it once a job is completed. How to send automated emails from Jenkins, how to send a notification to the Slack channel. So you having a mobile in your hand, you have a Slack app, you will get a notification in the app saying the job is completed and it is failed. Job is completed, it is passed. So all these details will be given to your mobile app. You no need to even log into your laptop, log into your Jenkins. All this notification will come automatically. You will say the build is deployed, the test is started, test is ended, test is failed, because of whatever reasons, right? So that is where this Slack kind of a channel is going to be important from the automated performance. So all these things are one which we are going to look into it from a Jenkins integration perspective, right? Starting from your load testing using JMeter, monitoring using AppDynamics, your tick stack, and then single user performance automation using Selenium, and then the GitHub and Slack integration. All these things are mostly part of your tool integrations, how to integrate and why to integrate, what is the use of it, all these things we are going to see in detail. And end of that, we'll also look into some of the important aspect of programming, right? You should also know about a little bit of Java, setting up your own Java environment. PowerShell scripts are going to be important, because there has to be few things you might need to write on your own to do some kind of cleanup work, maintenance work when it comes to automated performance testing, right? So we'll also quickly look into those importance of programming and a couple of important PowerShell commands, PowerShell scripts, which you will use it for your automated performance, okay? So all these things, 80% of thing, whatever I spoke about is going to be practical. Maybe 10, 20% will be theoretical. Okay, so let me just walk you through the different things, right? From this is what I was talking about. First, we'll learn Jenkins and JMeter, and then we will look into how to send the automated feedbacks, email notifications. Second thing, third is going to be more of a GitHub, fourth is Slack, and then fifth is continuous monitoring, right? All these things, one by one, progressively we'll try to learn. However, we will implement in a project accordingly, we'll try to go and learn these things. Okay. From Jenkins, yes, we will go and look into how to install the Jenkins, how to install the plugins, creating a pipeline, right? One job after another job. You might have a functional job, you might have some smoke testing jobs, you will have AppDynamics job, you will have a JMeter job. We'll see how to create these pipelines. Okay, so let me quickly go to the what I have it in my mission. Okay, I'll just quickly show you those things as well so that you will know exactly what you will get it. Okay, so we'll have this Jenkins running in my mission, and during the course as well we'll show from where to download the Jenkins and how to install it. Okay, and then so for each of this JMeter, AppDynamics, GitHub, Slack, all these things we will try to learn how to create the jobs, and then how to add plugins whenever it is required, and then how to configure those plugins for each of this job, right? For example, there is a this is the pipeline which I was talking about, right? One job after another job, how to create pipelines. We have a deployment job, we have a smoke testing job, we have a environment validation job, JMeter job, and then AppDynamics job, right? So each and every job, what it is doing, and how to configure it, how it is going to pick the scripts, how it is going to connect to the your GitHub, all these things as well, we will look into it in detail. For example, if I go to the Git JMeter, right? In that, if you see in the configuration, we will go and provide the Git URL, and then we need to authenticate with the your Git channel. We'll also see how to create your account in the Git. Okay, so over the those 2.5 hours plus 2.5 hours, we will try to cover as much as possible from these integration perspective. Okay, so this Git JMeter job will have the connection to the your GitHub, and then we will run some Windows batch command to run the JMeter, and then we'll also get the JTL file, and then we will send email notifications, we will also send the Slack notifications. So all these things we will try to learn practically from the Jenkins configuration. Okay, similarly AppDynamics as well, the AppDynamics is running the cloud, and it is connecting to my local application, and the Tomcat, I have a application running, Java application running, right? So this is the Java application for which I'll be running a JMeter scripts, and then that JMeter scripts is what we'll be integrating with the your Jenkins, and the data from this application is what it is getting collected in the AppDynamics. So what you will see it in the practical session is we will run a JMeter script which is going to it against a sample application which is running in my machine, and the monitoring will be done by AppDynamics, and from Jenkins all this will be governed. From Jenkins test will be started, and once the test is completed, you will get to know this whether the test is passed or failed, and there will be another job which will go and collect the data from AppDynamics, and that data will also be there in the Jenkins. Okay, so that is what we will try to learn how to do it from the course perspective. Okay, so let me quickly go to the AppDynamics job also. So this is the pipeline, what we will learn how to create the pipeline. Okay, so this is the AppDynamics performance trend, right? The response time, your calls per minute, and then your number of slow calls, number of very slow calls, exceptions, all these things, data will flow from your AppDynamics to the Jenkins, and we'll also try to learn how this continuous monitoring is going to work. So and similarly for GitHub, Slack also, we'll go and create the separate account in Slack, and we'll go and do the required configuration both from a Slack perspective, also from a Jenkins perspective, and see how both tools are going to communicate each other, and we will see how the notification is going to come into Slack as well. So the Slack, GitHub, JMeter, AppDynamics, your automated monitoring with the TickStack, All these things, everything is going to be practically is what we are going to look into it. Okay, so apart from this, yeah, pipeline execution is also we'll learn, and then similarly the programming skills for DevOps we'll try to do a discussion on what programming skills is required for DevOps, and we'll also practically see how to set up your Java environmental variables, which is something basic that is required for a performance tester in DevOps world, right? You should be probably able to set up some softwares, set up a Java environmental variables, execute some jar files, execute some Windows PowerShell scripts. We'll also cover a certain aspect of this Windows PowerShell scripts running from Jenkins. We'll also look into a couple of important PowerShell script itself, right? Creating shell scripts for Windows PowerShell scripts for copying, deleting files, removing your older scripts, removing your older results file. All this maintenance work, you need to do it because you need to archive your old scripts, archive your old results, so that your Jenkins can show you the current results, right? So for these things, Windows PowerShells are very much required. So we'll also look into that from this aspect. Okay, so pretty much this is what we will cover. Obviously you will learn all the required basics for integrating performance testing to DevOps pipeline. Again, the course is designed in such a way that it is not for a DevOps engineer. It is for the performance testing in DevOps. So whatever we are going to learn, it's very tailored made as per the requirement, what we see in the market, what we see in the real world, and just not learn too many things that will not even use it. So all these, whatever we are going to learn is something practically we will use it. We will practically what we need for a performance tester for him to work in a DevOps project. Okay, so that is what you will learn out of this crash course, and since it's a 5-hour crash course, right, I know it's going to be too much of a content, a lot of things we are going to cover, right? The Jenkins JMeter, AppDynamics, TickStack, Slack, GitHub, Selenium, all these things are various topics, and obviously whatever that is required for you to learn, whatever it is required for you to kickstart your journey, all of these things you will get it. Maybe not deep dive into everything, because of course it's a crash course where intention is for you to for us to upskill you to know what is required, and with this crash course definitely you'll be able to do all these things practically as well, because all these things are going to be open source tools, all these things are going to be trial versions that will be available for you to use it, right? So you can replicate all these things in your laptop, and we'll also provide access to the Google Drive and then Google Sheet, where we will provide all the links from where you can download it, where you can set it up, all these things in your machine, right? All these details will also be provided in the Google Drive, and we also will upload a few reusables, like your couple of Windows PowerShell scripts, and then your JMeter scripts, and then a couple of other screenshots from either from AppDynamics or TickStack, whatever that is required for you to have it as part of the documentation, that will also be available in the Google Drive for your future use. But especially your JMeter scripts and then your Jenkins related setup files and then your PowerShell scripts and then the sample Selenium script, right? All these things will be uploaded to Google Drive, which you can access it even after the course is completed. And as well as the once a course is completed, the video of the course will also be available in couple of days. So which means you will get the access to the videos as well once a course is completed, which you can refer it for your future reference as well. Okay, so that is all I wanted to cover as part of this demo session, giving a quick overview on all the things that we will cover in the 5-hour course. Okay. So if there are any questions, feel free to ask. I think there is a one question in the chat. Did we consider any open source monitoring tool integration with Jenkins? Okay. When it comes to continuous monitoring, right, there are two ways. One, you can pull data from the tool like AppDynamics or Dynatrace into Jenkins. That is what we are going to see, how to pull data from AppDynamics into Jenkins. And from open source perspective, right? So while the test is going on, one way is to get the reports into Jenkins. One way is to instead of me logging into each of the app servers and then looking into Puffmon, looking into the shell scripts, or looking into the top command, one more easier way is to just log into a dashboard and then looking into it, right? And not going into too many machines. In one single dashboard, if I can get all the CPU, memory, disk utilization of all the servers in a single dashboard, that is what the automated monitoring is all about. So that is something we look into it. We will not try to bring in that. We can still publish that dashboard link in the Jenkins. That is still possible. But more from open source monitoring perspective, we will look into what are those monitoring tools like Telegraph, InfluxDB, and then your Chronograph. So in my machine, I have these tools downloaded. We'll go and install those tools, and then we'll see how to configure the Telegraph, how to push the data to Influx, and then how to create dashboards in the Chronograph. So all these things, practically, we look into it. Okay. Next is, are you planning to cover integration of controller performance center with Jenkins, specifically for client who uses LoadRunner? So in the course, we will not cover it, but I can provide the information around it. In the course, we will cover JMeter, and probably I can provide you document on how to integrate performance center or LoadRunner with Jenkins. Since it's a 5-hour course, of course, we'll not be able to cover too much of things. And one more thing is, from a DevOps perspective, most of the places nowadays, JMeter is what it is preferred. So we'll look into the JMeter from a course perspective. If it is required, I can also provide you the document around this LoadRunner or performance center integration with Jenkins. Okay, so it is the same, the integration with Jenkins and with Azure, like creating pipeline and execution. See, to answer this question, right, there are going to be a lot of build tools. You have Jenkins, you have Bamboo, you have TeamCity, Azure DevOps pipeline is there. In AWS also, it has its own DevOps tools. There is going to be n number of DevOps tools, right, your build tools. Today, Jenkins is, of course, very popular, and it is there everywhere, most of the places. And tomorrow, after 6 months, one year, that could be another new tool that could be coming in, right? So that is going to be tool agnostics. So obviously, since Jenkins is famous, we are trying to learn Jenkins today. And similarly, when it goes to Bamboo or whatever tools in the future, it is going to be of a similar concept, right? So we are not going to master the tool at any point of time, because tools are going to keep changing. Even from a load testing, tools keep changing, right? So if it is going to be another new tool that is going to be there in your organization, the concepts are going to be a little similar, right? You need to integrate two tools. You need to integrate your Jenkins with JMeter, Jenkins with LoadRunner. That is one thing. So you should be able to start the test automatically. Second, you should be able to pull the report from the tool to your Jenkins or Bamboo, whatever it is. Second is pulling the report. Third is more about making your job pass or fail based on some criteria, some SLAs or errors. So all these capabilities, what you will be looking for in a tool, and you need to do it, right? And then integrating with the GitHub, integrating with Slack, right? So every tool, whatever you're going to look into, either it is Azure DevOps tool or it's going to be Bamboo, from functionality perspective, this is what you're going to do. You want to start the test. Once the test is completed, you need to pull the report, you need to pass or fail the job, you need to send a notification to email or Slack, and you might need to look for all these options, whether that is available within the that new tool or not. So once you know what to look for, you can easily find it for the new tools. Of course, you cannot go and learn all the 10 tools that are there in the market, right? You cannot learn Bamboo, you cannot learn TeamCity, you cannot learn Azure DevOps. You learn one, you start with one tool, you know how to do it, what to do it is very important, first of all. What to do it, and then how to do it, and then you just go into search for a similar options. Now you know what to do, you will do the same thing in other tools also, but only thing is, you need to know how to do. So in that case, you will have to go and search for the user manuals within TeamCity or within Bamboo, and then you will find out how to do it, and then you need to go and do it. So that is how you need to expand it. So people who know LoadRunner, they can easily use JMeter or new load, because they know they need to create scripts. They need to do recording, they need to do correlation, they need to do parameterization, error handling. All these concepts are going to be same, but only thing is, so they know what to do now. Now when they go from LoadRunner to NeoLoad, they will go and check for the user manual how to do it, how to do parameterization, how to do correlation. Similar concept. You will not master every load testing tool, right? But you are good in concepts. You know what to do, how the load testing tool works from a conceptual perspective. Similarly, it is applicable to DevOps also. You cannot master everything. Start from somewhere, understand what to do. That is what you're going to get it from the course. How to do, that is also we'll get it from a Jenkins perspective, and then you can expand it to any other tool. Okay, so yeah, any other question, guys, that you have? So this course, as I said, it's going to be the first session is going to be next week, the same time in which we started today, Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. And then similarly, the next day, Sunday, it's again going to be in the morning, 7:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. IST. If you have any other questions, right, even after this demo session is ended, if you have any questions, feel free to ask your questions in the group or privately. You can ping Naveen or me, and then you can ask your questions regarding the course or regarding the schedule, regarding the fees, regarding the timing. Whatever questions you have, please feel free to ask these questions before the registrations, and so that we can clarify your doubts. Okay, fine, guys. I think we'll then meet you next week. Thanks for your time, being a Saturday morning, Friday evening, whatever time zone you are. Thanks for taking up time to attend this demo session. Hopefully we'll meet again next week. Okay, thank you, guys.